Between the hometown Western Mustangs and the visiting Ryerson Rams, just underway here in the first period. Olivia Ross getting the starting net for the Western Mustangs this afternoon. Emma Crawley getting her fourth start of the season for the Ryerson Rams. Buster will bring it in for the Rams. Foot shot in on Ross for the first save of the afternoon. Olivia Ross comes into action this afternoon with a 1-2 record, good for 3.19 goals against and a 0.93 save percentage.
Are you talking about earpieces?
Wilson brings it across the blue line for the Mustangs. She'll dump it into the corner. Battling in the corner for it. Out in front, quick chance there for the Mustangs, unable to put it home. The Mustangs come into this afternoon's action after losing 2-1 to the York Lions last time out. Here's the Ryerson Rams come into action with a 1-12 record. Just a 1 win on the season. They'll be looking for just their second victory of the season here this afternoon. Ryerson will worry about the long pass in behind the net. 2 minutes into action here at Thompson this afternoon between the Western Mustangs and the Ryerson Rams.
Hey, Jeremy.
Strong defense for the Mustangs to start here this afternoon. Last time these two teams met back on October 28th at Ryerson University. 2 third period goals from Stacey Scott were the difference as the Western Mustangs were able to come away with a 4-1 victory. Kelly Campbell stopped 27 of 28 shots for the Mustangs in the victory as they got their first whistle. Before Ryerson was able to make any opportunity. Yeah. power play for the Rams. So we'll have a face off in the neutral zone. Ryerson will bring it across, 1:13 left in the power play. He shoots him in the corner for the Rams. Back to the blue line. Push off from Ryerson. That's right into the breadbasket of Olivia Ross, who will hold for the faceoff. Out to play the puck for the Rams. Emma Crawley comes into action this afternoon, 1-11 on the season. That lone victory. 4 goals against the average to go with an 880 save percentage. And she'll hold the puck behind her own net. Control the rebound, opportunity for the Rams, with another shot, another chance, and Ross will hold for the faceoff as the Ryerson Rams out to a very good start here this afternoon, looking for just their second victory on the season, all over the Mustangs here early. The Western Mustangs coming into action, looking for their sixth victory in the past 8 games. They've been able to go 5-2 in their past 7 games. We'll get another whistle and a penalty here, as it appears the Western Mustangs will head to their first power play opportunity of the afternoon. That'll be number 27 for the Rams. Monique, number 5, going to the box. That's actually going to be number 21. Kayla Thurston taking the penalty. Got tangled up in the neutral zone with the Western player as the Mustangs head to the power play. Scott with it in the corner. Saunders back at the point. Ryerson's able to clear the puck down the length of the ice. And Ross will have to play with former teammates to reverse. And behind Western's net now. Ryerson doing very well on this power play, not allowing Mustangs to apply any pressure in the early going of this power play. 1:28 remaining. Another penalty coming up here to Ryerson, as Katie Dillon was taken down just inside the blue line. And Lauren McCusker will head to the penalty box for the Rams. For the next 1:20, the Western Mustangs will have an opportunity to open the scoring with a 2-man advantage. Rolf wins the faceoff for the Mustangs. Back to the blue line. Opportunity out in front. Ryerson able to jump on it and clear it as Kirk Olsen just inside the blue line. Back to Kirk at the point. Kirk will let the shot go. That doesn't get through traffic, so he was knocked down just in front of Emma Crawley. 1:35 left in the 2-man advantage. That shot is fired just wide for the Mustangs. Faceoff as the Western Mustangs have finally found their legs here, applying plenty of pressure on this 2-man advantage. Still make a quick line change here for the faceoff. Venture Deller takes the faceoff for the Mustangs, who are able to control off the faceoff. Saunders at the blue line. broken up by the Rams defender. Saunders at the point now. Back to Peyton, show at the shot go. That one's knocked down just in front of the net. Rebound out in front. Bro is able to get the glove on it for the faceoff. Mustangs. She's unable to win it. 52 seconds remaining in the two-man advantage for the Mustangs. Turf just inside the point. That pass doesn't get through. Ryerson was able to intercept it. RC battling in the corner for the Rams. She's tripped up. No call on the play. Finally, we will get the whistle. Just as time was starting to wind down on the first power play, Rams head back to the penalty box to give the Western Mustangs 26 more seconds of a two-man advantage as the parade to the penalty box continues here in the opening period. Thompson Arena. Ryerson Rams, 1-12 on the year, not doing themselves any favors in the early going. As Western will set up once again, 20 seconds remaining, 5-on-3 power play action. Opportunity score! Mustangs get on the board, loose puck out in front. Able to jump on it, and it's a 1-0 hockey game. Just about 8 minutes into the action here as Stacy Scott was able to jump on the rebound, and it's a 1-0 hockey game. Mustangs will have 1:48 left of power play time. That goal coming on a two-man advantage. As Stacy Scott able to rip home her sixth goal of the season to go along with her 8 assists for 14 points. Saunders picks it up in front of her own net, now playing behind. Ryerson able to pick it up, loose puck, out in front. Rugby Ross a bit busy there, trying to keep that one out. Ryerson dumps that one all the way back in, and Saunders has to pick it up behind her own net. 1:22. Through the neutral zone. We hit the 11-minute mark here in the opening period. 9 minutes played. Western Mustangs won this game leading 1-0 over the Ryerson Rams. 35 seconds remaining in the power play for the Mustangs. Once again, Ryerson will head to the penalty box. It does look like it will be another tripping penalty, this time going against the Mustangs. Lindsay Kadomski takes a 2-minute minor. 4th-year senior out of Mississauga, Ontario, will sit for 2 minutes or less. We'll have 20 seconds of 4-on-4 action here between the Rams and the Mustangs. Ryerson looking to tie up the game. Brown able to keep it in for the Mustangs, just inside the blue line. That's dumped into the corner behind the Rams' net. Crowley will hold it up against the post for the whistle. 10:19 remaining here in the opening period of play. 3 more seconds of 4-on-4 action. Then the Ryerson Rams will have 1:33 of power play time to try and equalize this 1-0 lead. Around at the blue line, show at the shot go. That one gets through before being tipped wide. .120 of power play time now for the Rams. Custer will bring it across for the Rams. .104 remaining in the power play. McCusker passes over to the corner. Rams applying pressure behind the net. Opportunity as that pass goes just off the stick. Warrensburg is having these cleared into neutral zone. We'll get a whistle for offside. 46 seconds remaining in the power play for Ryerson. Ryerson brings it across the blue line, 30 seconds remaining in their power play, trying to find someone out in front. Western is playing very strong defense on the field here as that one is cleared down through the neutral zone. And behind the Ryerson net now, 15 seconds remaining on the power play. One last opportunity for the Rams to take advantage. That will do it for the power play. Ryerson unable to capitalize on their opportunity. As we are back even strength here with 8:35 remaining in the opening period here at Thompson Arena. And we'll go down the length of the ice. Crawley will come out to play it as both teams make line changes. 8:15 remaining here in the first period. Saunders chips it through the neutral zone before being knocked down by a Ryerson defender. Puck is caught up along the boards now. Both teams trying to dig it out. Western able to do so. Third stop that one just inside the blue line for the Mustangs. Out there with Rawls for the Mustangs. Kirk at the blue line. She'll hold and play it off the boards just in front of her own bench. Kirk with it once again. She'll pass that up to Filson, who dumps it into the corner. Bring it across the blue line for the Mustangs and into the corner. Deller will be harassed by two Ryerson defenders. This puck goes through the neutral zone and Brown has to take it out for the Mustangs once again. Had a bit of trouble with it as Paul is applying pressure for the Rams. Scott is taken down, and Ryerson will head back to the penalty box once again with 6:32 remaining in the opening period. Western Mustangs, who have already had a handful of power play opportunities in the period, will get a chance once again to double their lead here, leading 1-0. The strength of Stacy Scott's sixth goal of the season. They're looking for more here with 6:30 remaining in the period. From the blue line, that one's fired just wide as that tip down in front from Ross just went wide. Kirk at the blue line, show let that shot go, that's knocked down in front. Ryerson is able to scoop it up and clear it down the length of the ice. Kirk will bring it through for the Mustangs and play it off the boards. 1:30 remaining in the power play for the Mustangs. that's knocked down by a high stick will get a whistle before the faceoff. Mustangs able to control off the faceoff. That's going to be dumped into the corner by Scott. Ryerson able to get over there behind the row mat and pick it up. Put it to the neutral zone. Race for it now. Saunders is unable to get there for the Mustangs. Finally, Deller will bring it up from behind her own net and pass it up to Scott. Scott will bring it through the neutral zone for the Mustangs over the blue line and gets it by Ryerson, Rams defender, momentarily before getting caught up in the corner. RC in there for the Rams as both teams dig away for the loose puck. 22 seconds remaining in the power play for the Mustangs. That one's cleared down the length of the ice. 10 seconds remaining in the power play. That one's left behind. Saunders will pick it up as Klein will run out on the power play for the Mustangs, unable to capitalize on the opportunity. So we get another whistle for the faceoff. Battling for it into neutral zone as the puck is caught up once again. Hook shot there for the Mustangs. That's fired just wide. They'll pick it up behind the net once again. Filson passing off. Opportunity for the Mustangs to double up their lead. Unable to do so as Brawley turns that one away. Filson battling in the corner for the Mustangs. She'll chip it down to Brown at the blue line. That one clears the zone. And we'll get another whistle. And it appears it will be yet another penalty, this time for cross-checking. As Kim Brown, the freshman from Calgary, Alberta, will get the gate for the Mustangs. 2 minutes for cross-checking. And with 3:45 remaining in the open period, Ryerson Rams with an opportunity to tie up the game as Thurston will take the draw for the Rams. We'll redo that one. Thurston, this year senior from Ajax, Ontario, team captain for Ryerson Rams will take the draw. He wins it back to Custer at the blue line. Passes over, hook shot, that one's fired. Some deflection just wide. Picked up in the corner. Another opportunity for the Rams. Ross knocks that away with his stick into the corner. Ryerson doing a very good job on this power play opportunity, trying to tie up the game. 3:25 remaining in the opening period. 1:35 remaining in the power play opportunity. That one will be broken up. Here's a clear break for the Mustangs. In comes Filson all alone. Grasped by two defenders, big save there by Emma Crowley, standing tall in net for the Rams to keep this a 1-0 game as Wilson broke in all alone on the penalty kill. Was unable to capitalize as she was harassed by two Ryerson defenders. Crowley coming up with the save as the net was knocked off. The score remains 1-0, 3:04 remaining in the period, 1:19 left on the power play for the Rams. No control behind their own net. .45 remaining in the period, 58 seconds remaining in the power play. clear that down the length of the ice for the Mustangs. Crawley out to hold it behind her own net for the Rams. Galloway will chip that back through the neutral zone for the Mustangs. Nice careful retreat into her own corner to protect the puck before passing it off. Over 2 minutes remaining in the period, still the 1-0 lead for the Mustangs. Stacey Scott with her sixth goal of the season. Opportunity for the Rams, score! Emily Rhodes with the goal. The Toronto, Ontario freshman gets the Rams on the scoreboard. And with just under 2 minutes left to play, high hockey game. Hockey game, and Ross is a bit slow to get readjusted in the Western Mustangs net. It looks as though she's adjusting her pad, as Olivia Ross was unable to come up with that save. We'll pause a moment while she gets readjusted, as Rolf will take the draw for the Mustangs. McCusker for the Rams. Another penalty coming up here, this time going against the Mustangs. As Crawley makes her way to the bench for the extra man for the Rams. 1:25 remaining in the period means the Rams will start the second period on the power play as they are unable to capitalize on the opportunity here. As there'll be another cross-checking penalty, this time going to either the Malty, 5'7" freshman from Toronto, Ontario, gets the gate. 2 minutes for cross-checking. The Mustangs are able to clear that one down the length of the ice off the faceoff. Give it off. 15 seconds, time for maybe one last rush. The Rams will bring it out with just 10 seconds remaining. That one's played off the boards. Just 5 seconds remaining here in the open period. Time for one last shot. Shoot! And that will do it for the open period. Unable to jump on the rebound for the Rams, as they will start the second period with 39 seconds on the power play remaining. Ryerson Rams were able to tie up the hockey game. Emily Rose tying things at one after Stacey Scott converted for her sixth goal on the season. It's a 1-1 hockey game between the Western Mustangs and the Ryerson Rams here at Thompson Arena. We'll be back for the second period on Mustangs TV.
it's game day. Today, tomorrow, every day. And game face is our only face. We're not normal. Normal doesn't run everywhere or take a stopwatch to everything. Normal doesn't dedicate itself to never letting its customers down. Not a single one. Never, ever, ever. Normal doesn't live to beat the rush. Obsessed about out-the-door times? That's not normal. Counting pepperoni in your sleep? Not normal. Normal is average. Normal is ordinary. Normal is what people expect. Normal doesn't have pizza sauce flowing through its veins. The other guy is normal. That's why no one delivers like we do. Itself to never letting its customers down. Not a single one. Never, ever, ever. Normal doesn't live to beat the rush. Obsessed about out-the-door times? That's not normal. Counting pepperoni in your sleep? Not normal. Normal is average. Normal is ordinary. Normal is what people expect. Normal doesn't have pizza sauce flowing through its veins. The other guy is normal. That's why no one delivers like we do.
What is the good life? It's about being totally alive in every fiber, every thought, every moment. It isn't complicated. It's as simple as letting your body move. Good life's not about magazine covers, it's about pictures on your mantle. It's not about what you see in a mirror, but about what you see inside. Yes, the good life does include ice cream, pizza, and a cold beer on a hot day. Good life is putting down the remote and taking control. It's about playing with your kids in the park and feeling like a kid yourself. It's about balance in a world that often forgets the meaning of that word. Good life is hearing your name and seeing a familiar smile. Good life is good, and it's within your reach. Grab it now. It's a good life out there.
If I get a good job, I'm gonna steal two bases.
Combine training. Let's go!
Yeah!
Welcome back to Thompson Arena here at the University of Western Ontario. OUA women's hockey action here this afternoon. All tied up at one goal apiece after the opening period. Both teams capitalizing on their power play opportunities. 20 seconds remaining in power play for the Rams. Early pressure here in the second period. Olivia Ross able to hold on to the faceoff. As the Ryerson Rams come into action this afternoon with just one win on the season, looking for their second victory. And if they keep on playing the way they have through the first period, they may just snake away the victory from the Mustangs, who will be looking for their sixth victory in the past eight games as they come in 5-2 in their past seven. As mentioned, both teams were able to capitalize on their power play opportunities in the first period. Stacey Scott scored her sixth goal of the season. Kenton Deller with the assist. Opportunity for the Rams. That's just off the net. Early pressure here from Ryerson to start the second period. Back to even strength. As once again, the Western Mustangs are on their toes in the early going of this period. Olivia Ross able to snag that puck and hold on for the faceoff. Stacey Scott's goal came at the 7:56 mark of the opening period before Ortonsburg was able to capitalize on the power play opportunity for the Rams at 18:04 mark. That was her fourth goal of the season to tie things up one goal apiece. Another opportunity for the Rams as Cornette throws that one at the net. The Rams held the lead in shots on goal 10-9 coming into the second period and have been firing the pucks at Ross to start the second period here. As the action has been all in the Rams. 3-1 coming up here for Mustangs. Dillon throws that one. Matt Crowley, who holds on for the faceoff. Matt Crowley coming into action this afternoon for the Rams. 1-11 on the season. 4.04 goals against. 880 save percentage. 2-on-1 opportunity here for the Rams, unable to capitalize on the opportunity as that was broken up by the Mustangs. Back to Turk. Unable to get a shot on net here as we hit the 2-minute mark of the second period. Yadomski with the opportunity as she brings it across the line for the Mustangs. Ended very well by the Rams. Mustangs bent on the shot. They continue to apply pressure. Roth just bans on the opportunity. Standing right out in front of Crowley. He was unable to get a good shot away. As that puck is into the bench and we'll have a face-off. As the Rams were able to bring it across the blue line off the faceoff in the neutral zone. Mustangs are bringing through the neutral zone and over the blue line. That one's broken up by the Ryerson defense. Virtual will fire it in for the Mustangs. That one goes all the way along the boards. Brown passes it over. Opportunity for the Mustangs. Good shot! Off the side of the net once again. Mustangs unable to put that one home. They were trying to reply with pressure of their own after Ryerson Rams came out fast and furious in the opening 2 minutes of the second period here. As Saunders is back to touch up for icing and face off all the way down to Ryerson's zone. Galloway will take the drop for the Mustangs. We'll do that one again as we get a whistle ringing back to the faceoff circle. 11-9 are the shots for Ryerson. Galloway wins it back. Their defense is out. This fire is just wide. Galloway in the corner. She'll play that off the boards down their own net. Out in front. Opportunity for the Mustangs here. Conway Avis knocked home. Looks like Cole had a chance on it. The Mustangs steal. Jump on rebound. Take the 2-1 lead. Controls off the faceoff, they'll dump that into the corner. Came out of the find the pressure to start the second period, unable to capitalize upon their opportunities. We'll get another whistle for a faceoff down in the Western zone. They'll get a partial 2-on-1, pressing hard to the net. Penalty coming up. Ryerson player knocked over the defender for Western as the Mustangs will head back to the power play. Hey, who got that second goal?
Like,
make it a 2-1 lead here and take that back to the power play, trying to double up on the Rams here. Wasn't able to pick it up and not clear the zone, that's how they're at the blue line for the Mustangs. They're all battling there along the boards. That one's going to stay out of the netting. From the blue line, quick shot in on Crowley, unable to control the rebound, picked up by a Ryerson defender, fired into the neutral zone. Ross will leave it behind her own net, picked up by the Mustangs as they try to regroup here. 1:13 remaining on the power play, 2-1 lead for the Mustangs. Under a minute left now on the power play. Cycling through Ryerson. Chance there for the Mustangs. Unable to get a stick on it at the side of the net. Finally, Ryerson is able to pick it up and clear the zone as Turk will retreat through the neutral zone and try and reset here with 40 seconds remaining on the power play. Ryerson brings it across the blue line first and doesn't get a shot away as that one's deflected into the corner. brings it up for the Mustangs. Just 15 seconds remaining on power play opportunity. Time taking away one last chance here. Thompson with the shot, rebound out in front. Crowley protecting the side post very nicely for the Ryerson net. Not allowing any shot. That will do it for the man advantage. We are back to even strength. The Western Mustangs are set back to 1-for-5 on the power play here this afternoon. And Dylan will bring it in for the Mustangs. Scott there as well. Into the corner. Scott battling. Line just past the own bench. That fired just wide. Crowley tried to snag that one with the glove. He's unable to get the mitt on it. Battling behind the net now. Just over 12 minutes remaining here in the second period. Western Mustangs leading 2-1. On interrogation. Really the goal. Out in front, unable to get backhander away, back to the blue line. That was fired just right off the body out in front, making a 3-1 game. They have gone off the Ryerson player. Nonetheless, making it a 3-1 game. Doesn't matter how you get it. Goes off the body in front, and it's a 3-1 lead for the Mustangs as the Rams win the faceoff. Just under 12 minutes remaining here in the second period. Western Mustangs starting to take advantage. For the Mustangs. Just the one victory on the year for the Rams. They'll have their work cut out for them if they are to make it 2 on the year. As the Mustangs applying pressure very hard here in the second period. Opportunity once again out in front. Ryerson net, there was a loose puck. Battling along the boards. Both teams fighting for the loose puck. Finally, the Mustangs will throw it into the corner and try and reset things here in the offensive zone. Ryerson will pick it up and bring it up through the neutral zone. Turk will pick it up in their own zone. For the Mustangs, as that's played through the neutral zone. Just under 10 minutes remaining here in the second period of play. It's been heavily dominated by the Mustangs. Scott will give chase behind the Ryerson net. Losing the boards a bit hard. With Kurt there for the Rams. Scott comes out with it back to the blue line. Trying to find someone out in front. Opportunity here. That one's fired. Another rebound picked up. Back to the blue line. Rams doing everything they can to try and get a stick on it. Finally able to do so, unable to clear the zone. So that one's finally flipped into the neutral zone as Brown blows the tire. Opportunity here, Rams. As that's defended very well by Gosling. As that one's fired down the length of the ice for the icing call. 8:54 remaining in period number two. These two teams played back on October 28th. Western Mustangs able to come away with the 4-1 victory thanks in part to Stacey Scott's third period goals. As Kelly Campbell stopped 27 of 28 shots in the 4-1 victory. Opportunity here for the Rams. That one's deflected just wide of the net. Trying to claw their way back into this one as the second period has gone away from them just a little bit. Hadowing in the corner. Hadowing in the corner of the 15. Now stuck there for the Mustangs. Another opportunity for the Mustangs, able to get a shot away. That one's fired just wide. Penalty coming up here. This one will go to number 27 for the Western Mustangs. Chuck headed to the box. 2 minutes for the head check, I think, is the call. 7:43 remaining in the second period. Ryerson Rams will head back to the power play after they were able to capitalize on their power play opportunity in the first period. Opportunity here for the Rams to get back into this hockey game. Into the corner, another penalty coming up here to the Mustangs. Hard check just outside the corner. Iowa Thurston was taken down. It will be a two-man advantage for the next minute 48 for the Rams. The Mustangs are not making things easy on themselves here with 7:31 remaining in the second period. Opening the door for the Rams to get back into this one. Two-man advantage for the Rams. They battle along the boards of the faceoff. Kearns getting the gate for cross-checking here. 1:28 remaining in the two-man advantage. Ryerson tries to get things set up, coming out from behind their own net, up through the neutral zone. That one fired in, scores! Looked like it may have been going wide. Somehow it found the back of the net. Ryerson Rams on the two-man advantage, cut the lead in half. They get a 3-2 lead for the Mustangs. Still 1:27 left on the power play for Ryerson. Just under 7 minutes remaining in the second period of play. Western Mustangs clinging to a 3-2 lead. As the Ryerson Rams are able to capitalize on the two-man advantage. Making it a 3-2 hockey game. 1:10 remaining on the power play. Saunders will pick it up in the corner for the Mustangs. Emily Rose is going to get credit for the Ryerson goal. for second on the season as that one's fired into the corner. Still 50 seconds remaining, finally cleared to the blue line and not out by the Mustangs. That one finally gets out. Ryerson stepping things up here on the power play. Just 40 seconds remaining on the man advantage. The ball being harassed in the corner. No one there to really help her. She tries to hold the puck up along the boards for a whistle. And it looks like she will finally get the whistle for the faceoff. 28 seconds remaining on the power play. Emily Rose with her third goal on the year, cutting this Mustang lead in half. 3-2 lead for Western, 6 minutes remaining in the second period, 25 seconds remaining on the power play. Shorthanded chance here for the Mustangs. They kick in behind the net. They'll bring it out. Thurston will take the shot. That's fired just off the Western net. 5 more seconds left in the man advantage. And we are back to even strength. Thurston stick landing, stick handling for the Rams. She'll throw it on net. Ross will cover up for the faceoff as the Western Mustangs are very lucky to have killed off power play. As Ryerson showing signs of life, cutting into the lead. 5:22 remaining in the second period of play here at Thompson Arena this evening. Rolf wins the draw for the Mustangs. Tripped up in the corner, no call on the play. Rolf there battling for the Mustangs. She's able to get it over to Gosling. Fires it along the boards behind her own net. Gosling will pick it up in the corner for the Mustangs. She'll fire that through the neutral zone. Looks like it may have been touched in the neutral zone, so no icing on the play. Out in front, opportunity, quick shot, score! Coach trying to get an explanation from the official. Not too sure what her case may be. Stonsky pushes away her second goal of the year. Getting the 2-goal lead for the Mustangs. They're going to bring it right back in for Western. Trying to find Kelly out in front. Here, number 8. Out in front, quick shot, and that's fired just wide. High and over the net. 14 spotting along the boards. Just under 4 minutes remaining in the period. Opportunity here for the Mustangs. That one's fired just wide and over the net on the back end. .105 remaining on the power play. Ryerson with an opportunity, throws it in on Ross. Bruce puck out in front, unable to control the rebound. Power play for the Mustangs. Very strong penalty kill from the Rams here. Both teams battling in front of the Western net. Dylan is in there for the Mustangs. And finally, a whistle for a faceoff. Off in the neutral zone, just in front of the Mustangs bench. As Western is able to control in the neutral zone. 28 seconds remaining on their power play. 3 minutes remaining here in the second period. As Gosling brings it across the blue line for the Mustangs. Battling in the corner, Gosling trying to find someone out in front. Back to the blue line, quick fire, just wide. Gosling will pick it up once again. The line, push shot. Raleigh able to get a stick on that one and deflect it out. And this one will go down the length of the ice. Ross plays it up. We're back to even strength. 2:25 remaining in the period. Zdenski back out after scoring his second goal of the season, making a 4-2 lead for the Mustangs. Sure. At the point, let the shot go. That one's deflected wide. Opportunity here for the Rams. That one's fired in behind the net and into the corner. Under 2 minutes remaining in the period. Now 1:55 to be exact. Battling along the boards. McCusker is there for the Rams. And finally a whistle as neither team is able to advance the action. So we'll get a face-off here with 1:48 remaining. Mellett will head back to the box for Ryerson. We'll wait for confirmation on the call. 1:48 remaining in the second period, and the Western Mustangs will get a 2-minute power play. Get explanation from the official on the penalty call. Obviously in disagreement. Kayla Thurston, fifth year senior, Ajax, Ontario. Team captain for the Rams, pleading her case. Game penalty to the Rams. An untimely one. There's just 1:30 remaining in the period. Dylan bringing it in for the Mustangs. Quick shot. Raleigh able to snag it and hold for the faceoff. 1:40 remaining in the power play, which may very well carry over to the third period as we have just 1:28 remaining in the second period of play. Ryerson able to pick it up off the faceoff. 1-1 opportunity here. Saunders is there. Nice move from the Ryerson player. Ross with the better save. Keeping that one out. Mustangs coming down the other way. Dylan battling through traffic, trying to find someone out in front, all the way into the corner as Kurt will lay down on it. We'll get a faceoff. Ryerson player is obviously a bit frustrated as Saunders goes down. And it appears that Saunders will get the gate as well as Ryerson player. Not sure This one we'll figure out, as it will be two players headed off for the Rams. We need a moment to figure out these calls. Two penalties to Ryerson. Saunders with the lone call for the Mustangs. Possibly for a bit of a dive on Saunders, you might think. She was knocked down, but referees used it differently. Just over a minute left here in the second period. Three penalties on the play. Mustangs with the initial 1:16 remaining on their power play. As the clock now starts to run. And we will try and figure out these penalty calls here. Just inside the blue line, passes it off to the side of the net. That one's intercepted. Just 15 seconds remaining in the second period. The puck is cleared out of the zone. That might do it for the second period. And the Western Mustangs will start the third period of 13 seconds. A two-man advantage, 59 seconds of power play. Busy second period here at Thompson Arena as the Western Mustangs will head to the locker room with a 4-2 lead. Watching OUA women's hockey action between the Western Mustangs and the Ryerson Rams. Back from the third period.
Doesn't dedicate itself to never letting its customers down. Not a single one. Never, ever, ever. Normal doesn't live to beat the rush. Obsessed about out-the-door times? That's not normal. Counting pepperoni in your sleep? Not normal. Normal is average. Normal is ordinary. Normal is what people expect. Normal doesn't have pizza sauce flowing through its veins. The other guy is normal. That's why no one delivers like we do.
What is the good life? It's about being totally alive in every fiber, every thought, every moment. It isn't complicated, it's as simple as letting your body move. The good life's not about magazine covers, it's about pictures on your mantle. It's not about what you see in a mirror, but about what you see inside. Yes, the good life does include ice cream, pizza, and a cold beer on a hot day. The good life is putting down the remote and taking control. It's about playing with your kids in the park and feeling like a kid yourself. It's about balance in a world that often forgets the meaning of that word. Good life is hearing your name and seeing a familiar smile. Good life is good, and it's within your reach. Grab it now.
If I get a good job, I'm gonna steal two bases.
It's combine training. Let's go!
Desperate and broken. fight. Father has spoken.
Face
is our only face. We're not normal. Normal doesn't run everywhere or take a stopwatch to everything. Normal doesn't dedicate itself to never letting its customers down. Not a single one. Never, ever, ever. Normal doesn't live to beat the rush. Obsessed about out-the-door times? That's not normal. Counting pepperoni in your sleep? Not normal. Normal is average. Normal is ordinary. Normal is what people expect. Normal doesn't have pizza sauce flowing through its veins. The other guy is normal. That's why no one delivers like we do.
What is the good life? It's about being totally alive in every fiber, every thought, every moment. It isn't complicated. It's as simple as letting your body move. The good life's not about magazine covers. It's about pictures on your mantle. It's not about what you see in a mirror, but about what you see inside. Yes, the good life does include ice cream, pizza, and a cold beer on a hot day. The good life is putting down the remote and taking control. It's about playing with your kids in the park and feeling like a kid yourself. It's about balance in a world that often forgets the meaning of that word. Good life is hearing your name and seeing a familiar smile. Good life is good, and it's within your reach. Grab it now.
Second period of play, Western Mustangs will have a 48 second power play opportunity here to start the second period. This time runs out on the two-man advantage. Opportunity right out in front, right away. That one's fired just wide. And we'll get another whistle, and it appears yet another penalty coming up. The Ryerson Rams. It has been a parade to the penalty box here this afternoon for Ryerson. They have not made things easy on themselves. Coming into action with just one victory on the season, they are heading back to the penalty kill. It'll be 33 seconds of 5-on-3 power play action for the Mustangs as they try to put this game away, leading 4-2 here at the start of the first period. Gosling tried to play that over to Deller before it was intercepted by a Ryerson defender. That will be dumped in on Ross, who will hold momentarily before giving it away to a teammate. That was Gosling who received the pass from Ross. That one's fired just back in. Ross turns it away with the stick as Deller tries to bring it across the blue line and into the neutral zone. Chance there for the Mustangs, since that was fired just high and over the net. That one will go down the length of the ice. No icing on the play. The Western Mustangs looking for their sixth victory in 8 games here if they are able to hold on here in the third period. As mentioned, the Ryerson Rams just one victory on the year, and it does not look like they will get that second victory. 50 seconds remaining on the 5-on-4 power play. 5-on-3 was killed off as Crowley holds for the faceoff. The second game of this doubleheader at Thompson Arena will go at 7:30 this evening as the number 4 Western Mustangs men's hockey team will take on the visiting Brock Badgers. That one going in just over an hour and a half time. Burke at the blue line keeps it in for the Mustangs. Lost swing just inside the blue line, trying to make a play for the Mustangs, and she skates it into the corner. Cross swing, trying to find someone out in front. That pass is eluded and off the boards as Sir has to regroup. That's fired just wide. As the Mustangs were unable to control the rebound. 10 seconds remaining on the power play. And that one will go down the length of the ice. Western Mustangs unable to take advantage of the 5-on-3 power play. Opportunity here for the Rams. They're trying to fight their way back into this game. RC trying to keep it in for the Rams. Just so momentarily before that one's cleared down the length of the ice, it will be icing, bringing the faceoff all the way back down to the Western zone. The Western Mustangs are back in action tomorrow afternoon here at Thompson Arena. 2:30 puck drop as they will take on the Toronto Varsity Blues. Busy weekend for Mustangs hockey, as the men's team won 5-2 last night against UOIT. It was a 5-2 victory for the Mustangs, their 10th on the season. Just one loss on the year for the men. The women leading 4-2 here this afternoon into the early evening against the Ryerson Rams. They are back in action, as I mentioned, more afternoon against Toronto. That one at 2:30. Once again, all games can be seen on Mustangs TV. Battling in front of the benches once again. Rolf with it for the Mustangs. Gadomski with her. That one fired just off the pad of Crawley. Hampson chuck there for the Mustangs, battling just outside the corner. That one knocked down, keeping it in for the Mustangs before Thurston brings it out for the Rams. Thurston over the blue line, tries to get by Kearns, unable to do so as Kearns stick goes flying. Pass this truck, unable to get a stick on it as that one goes down for icing, and another faceoff coming down the length of the ice. Just over 16 minutes remaining here in the third period. Be sure to stick with us here on Mustangs TV as we'll be bringing you live coverage of the Western Mustangs men's game coming up in just over an hour's time as they take on the Brock Badgers. Miller holding it just inside the blue line for the Rams. Gadomski will pick it up for the Mustangs and clear it over the blue line as she passes off. This one going to be offside, delayed offside as Ryerson is able to pick it up as Western was regrouping in the neutral zone. Ryerson brings it up now, trying to claw back into this one. That one fired just wide. Olivia Ross didn't have to really move on that shot. Once the truck is taken out hard, as Rosen tried to play that over for Mellinger. Rams bring it in over the blue line. That shot doesn't get through traffic. The Mustangs defense doing a good job knocking that one down as Mellinger gives chase here for the Mustangs. Unable to control as we hit the 5-minute mark here of the third period. Battling in the corner now behind the net. Opportunity here for the Mustangs. That one fired just off the pad of Crawley. It was nearly a 5-2 game for the Mustangs. And we will get another whistle as the Western Mustangs will get the gate. 14:44 remaining in regulation. 4-2 lead for the Mustangs. They will tempt their fate a little bit here as they will head to the penalty kill. Ryerson with an opportunity to make this a one goal game. Shot from the blue line right into the basket of Olivia Ross. held on for the whistle before dumping the puck into her own net. Well, after the whistle. Ryerson controls off the faceoff once again, fires a quick shot, and Olivia Ross knocks that one away. Geller will pick it up on the backhand and clear it to the blue line, not being able to clear there. Quick shot there on the backhand, right off the pads of Olivia Ross, who did not look quite ready for that shot. Back to the blue line, quick shot, that one moves out in front. Picked up finally by the Mustangs. Ryerson with another golden opportunity on the power play. Although they are trailing this game 4-2, they have to be happy with how they played on the power play. Yet another opportunity taken out hard by Turk. And with 1:15 remaining on the initial power play, the Ryerson Rams will get a two-man advantage. Just under 14 minutes left to play here in the third period. The Western Mustangs will have to kill off a 5-on-3 penalty. And it appears that Ryerson will call a timeout. Try and get their power play unit ready for this next 1 minute and 15 seconds of 5-on-3 power play action. Although the Western Mustangs lead this game 4-2, they are not making life easy on themselves. Still plenty of time for the Rams to make a game of this one in search of just their second victory on the year. Head coach of the Rams, Lisa Jordan, trying to rally the troops with the timeout, trying to get the power play all set up. They'll head out for a two-man power play. 5-on-3 advantage for the next minute 15. And then they will have 45 seconds of 5-on-4 power play. They're unable to capitalize. Opportunity, that one fired just wide. Body checking is the call to the Mustangs. Hartchuk tries to throw that in front. Unable to find a Ram stick as they regroup once again. Now behind the net, that one's picked up by the Mustangs, fired off the boards, unable to clear the zone as Hartchuk keeps it in for the Rams' opportunity here. That one behind the net. Awesome, taken out hard by the Rams player. Ground there for the Mustangs as well. She gives it off to Ross, who holds it up against the post, gets the whistle before the puck squirts free. 35 seconds remaining on the two-man advantage. 1:20 on the second power play. So we take a look at that last chance for Rams. As you see, Russ pulls it up against the post before it squirts free. Drops the whistle for the faceoff. Rams control off the draw. Mullet passes off, quick shot, that one's fired wide. Off the boards, back to Mullet. Mullet with two minor penalties in the game, passes off. Opportunity here for the Rams, quick shot. Olivia Ross standing holding strong in net. As the Mustangs play that off the boards and back to the blue line. Rams keeping it in once again. Just 10 seconds remaining on the two-man advantage. Opportunity, loose puck out in front. And finally, Ross gets a glove on it and brings it in, holding for the faceoff. Just 5 seconds remaining on the power play as we take a look at that last opportunity. 5 seconds remaining on the two-man advantage, then 45 seconds of 5-on-4 power play action. Rams control off the faceoff, backhanded over the net. One man is out for the Mustangs. 38 seconds remaining in the power play. That one gets by everyone. Dylan Drew here with the chance. That one into the corner, picked up by the Rams. They'll play it up through the neutral zone. That was Thurston with it momentarily for the Rams, unable to control as Saunders has it in her own zone. Tried to clear it right off Thurston's chest. Opportunity here for the Rams. the Mustangs able to control the rebound and clear it through the neutral zone. The Rams will reset, and that will do it for the power play. The Western Mustangs able to kill off both penalties as Russ pulls for the faceoff, and yet another penalty upcoming, this time going to Tyler Thurston, team captain for the Ryerson Rams, and after they were unable to take advantage of the 5-on-3 power play opportunity of their own, they will send the Western Mustangs to a 2-minute power play with a 4-2 lead. Rolf takes the draw and wins it for the Mustangs. Back to Gosselin just inside the blue line, fakes the shot. Wade along the boards and into the corner. Rolf with it. Show turn. Back to Gosling at the blue line, who passes off to her defender. Quick shot there. That one gets through and into the corner off the pads of Crawley, who made the initial save. Rams will pick it up in their own corner, unable to clear the zone as the Mustangs are able to pick that one up. Gosling at the blue line. Back to Turk. Turk lets the shot go. Crawley with the initial save. Can't control the rebound. Still loose in front of the net. And finally, Crawley will jump on the rebound. Western Mustangs had the loose puck, could not find it before Emma Thurston able to cover up. 1:15 remaining on the power play, 11:10 left in the third period. The Western Mustangs leading the Ryerson Rams 4-2 here at Thompson Arena. Deller in to take the draw for the Mustangs. The Ryerson player is tossed out of the faceoff circle. Deller wins the draw. Mustangs unable to control it off the faceoff as Ryerson will clear out of the zone. And the Mustangs will have to reset with just over a minute left on the power play. Here comes Stacy Scott, already with one goal in the game, unable to make the move in front of the net. And Saunders is unable to hold it in, as Haitian will have to retreat all the way back to find your own net and regroup. 47 seconds remaining on the power play. Scott brings it up through the neutral zone before passing it. Trying to find someone out in front. Saunders is there as well as Scott. Haitian back at the blue line. Saunders lets the shot go right into Crawley's pads. Pounding on it out in front. Crawley covers up. Bit of rough stuff after the whistle. It's not appear any penalties will be called, as now a Ryerson player will make her way to the penalty box, giving the Western Mustangs 27 seconds of 5-on-3 advantage here. Just over 10 minutes remaining in the hockey game. Once again, the Mustangs leading 4-2. Deller unable to win the faceoff. Rams play that off the boards and clear the zone. Just 20 seconds remaining on the 5-on-3, and then it will be a one-man advantage for the Mustangs. Scott brings it through the neutral zone for the Mustangs and chips it over the blue line into the corner. RC will pick it up for the Rams. Scott right in there battling hard for the Mustangs. Ryerson able to kill off the 5-on-3. Now 1:25 remaining on the one-man advantage. Score! Stacey Scott chips it home from the side of the net for the second goal of the game. Make it 5-2 Western Mustangs. Stacey Scott with her 7th goal on the season. And that will all but do it for the Mustangs. Make it 5-2. And the way this game has been going, you would think that 3-goal cushion should be enough. With 9:44 left here in the third period. After starting the season 1-5, the women's Mustangs have turned things around, snaring their 6th victory nice save from Ross, unable to control the rebound. Opportunity there for the Rams. If perhaps I have spoken too soon as they are here applying pressure. Never City die. Ryerson Rams, just one victory on the year. Not to be discouraged here. As we hit the 11-minute mark of the third period. Up through the neutral zone as the Rams are able to clear it. That one just inside the blue line, offside for the whistle. Just over 8.5 minutes left here in the third period. The ladies are back in action tomorrow afternoon, taking on Toronto Varsity Blues. That's a 2:30 puck drop here at Thompson Arena. If you can't make it out, be sure to tune in to Mustangs TV here on the SSN Canada Network. Haitian just inside the blue line. That was deflected. Mustangs applying pressure once again here. Trying to add to their 5-2 lead. Opportunity out in front, unable to control as Ryerson picks it up. They'll bring it up through the neutral zone. Opportunity here, that one fired just wide of the net. Cornette trying to control things for the Rams in the neutral zone. Gives that one away as two players collide. That one's down into the corner. As the Mustangs player bobbles to the bench, looks to be okay as Ryerson regroups behind their own net and comes out with it. Trying to get fancy at the blue line as that one's given away. Mustangs in their own zone, just in front of their own bench. Rams will bring it up through the neutral zone once again. A 1-on-3 rush will not materialize as Saunders picks it up for the Mustangs behind their own net and comes out with it. Opportunity here, that one's just ahead as Crowley is able to come out and play that one into the corner. Rolf behind the net for the Mustangs, being pressed by two defenders for Ryerson. That one's chipped along the corner boards. That shot doesn't get through, and it's back into the neutral zone as Turf will have to regroup the Mustangs as she passes off to Saunders. That one will get chipped at the blue line, down behind Rams net as both teams regroup. As Dower picks it up in the neutral zone and chips it in. In behind the Rams net now, Scott is there for the Mustangs. Deller there as well along with her as it goes into the corner and up along the boards. Deller is taken out. Out in front now, quick shot, score! 80 Dillon makes it 6-2 for the Mustangs. After a very slow start in the opening period, Western Mustangs taking full control of this game in the second and third period. 4-goal lead, they get 6-2 on Katie Dillon's goal. Keep it a 6-2 lead for the Mustangs. That puck had back of the net destination written all over it. But Olivia Ross doing a very good job spreading across the crease to keep that one out. Olivia Ross looking for her second victory on the year, came into action with 3.19 goals against average. Just two goals allowed here this afternoon. So that goals against average will drop. Get another faceoff just in front of the Ryerson bench here. 5:31 remaining in regulation. 6-2 hockey game for the Mustangs. This game well in hand. Rolf dumps it now behind the net. Rams will pick it up behind their own net, being harassed by the Mustangs. Sniffing for that seventh goal here, just 5 minutes remaining in regulation. Nation will skate back and pick it up at the far end of the neutral zone for the Mustangs. Tried to chip it into the zone, but the Rams doing a good job keeping it out. In the neutral zone, Rams chip it down. In behind the Western net now. Kearns was there. Giving it off to Scott. Hilson there for the Mustangs. Just at the blue line as that one was fired just wide of Ross. Give Ryerson credit. They have not quit in this game. Although they trail 6-2, they are not hanging their heads, battling very hard in the closing minutes of this contest. They'll be back in action later next week. The Western Mustangs right back to the grind tomorrow afternoon, taking on the Toronto Varsity Blues. 2:30 puck drop here at Thompson Arena. Ryerson brings it across the blue line, fires it in on Ross. Will hold once again for the draw. 3:45 remaining here in the third period. Be sure to stick around here on Mustangs TV as we will be bringing you action of the men's game coming up at 7:30. The 10-1-2, number 4 in the CIS Western Mustangs taking on the Brock Badgers. That's a 7:30 puck drop. Just about an hour's time from now. 3:33 remaining in the women's game here. It has been all Western all day, leading 6-2 as Nastchuk brings it in. Quick shot in on Crowley. Unable to control the rebound, unable to find the rebound. As the Mustangs not taking their foot off the pedal here. As Ryerson finally able to pick it up, clears through the neutral zone. Thurston with it, trying to make a move past the last defender. Saunders is there for the Mustangs. Make sure that Thurston's opportunity was defended as the puck now goes down through the neutral zone as Rellinger gives chase for the Mustangs. That one's chipped down behind the Ryerson net. Just 2:40 remaining in the contest now. Out in front, another opportunity, quick shot. Crowley doesn't know where it is. The Ryerson defender is able to pick it up and clear the zone. 2:24 remaining in the contest as Scott plays it in the neutral zone here for the Mustangs as they bring it across the blue line and into the corner. Trying to find someone out in front, shoot, score! 7-2, Western Mustangs, not sure who put that one home. Looked like Crowley had a piece of it, not the case. 2:12 remaining in the contest. Might be the hat trick goal for Stacey Scott. We will wait for confirmation. But the Western Mustangs ladies hockey team just 2 minutes and 12 seconds away from their sixth victory in 8 games. Mustangs. Katie Dillon, goal scorer for the Western Mustangs. That's her 10th on the year. Very impressive offensive numbers from Katie Dillon for the Mustangs, making it 7-2 here against Ryerson this afternoon. That one fired down. 1:30 remaining in the third period. In a game heavily dominated by the Western Mustangs, Ryerson has stuck around, unable to capitalize on the opportunities. It's 1:15 now remaining in the third period. That one will get fired down the length of the ice. No icing on the play, as we now have under 1 minute remaining in the hockey game. Looks as though the Western Mustangs might finally be content with a 7-2 score. The Rams trying to cut into that lead. Whatever happens from here on in for the Rams will be far too little, far too late. That one fired just wide. Olivier Ross may have had a piece of it. 30 seconds remaining in the game now. That one chipped just in front of the Mustangs bench. Rolf there for the Mustangs. Under 20 seconds now, trying to find someone out in front is Rolf in the corner. She's harassed by a Ryerson Rams defender. We will get one last penalty call here. That'll be Nina Moletti headed to the box. Just 7 seconds remaining in the contest. And after starting the season 1-5, the Mustangs women's hockey team has started to find their footing as they will win their 6th game in their past 8. And that will all but do it for this one. Time will run out. And Western Mustangs win their 16th, their last 8, making a 7-2 final. Ryerson Rams still just that one victory on the season, make it 1-13. Awfully tough record to play with, but give them credit, did not quit here in the third period. As the Western Mustangs defeat the Ryerson Rams 7-2. Stick with us here on Mustangs TV. We will be back in just under an hour's time. As number 4 Western Mustangs men's team takes on the Brock Badgers. We'll see you then on Mustangs TV.